We're back again for another episode of Turntable Techniques, brought to you by DJ City and Beat Refinery. I'm DJ AZ1, and today we're gonna go over some basic scratch techniques and combine them into what is known as the Rocket Scratch. Herbie Hancock's hit song, Rocket, featured Grand Mixer DXT's Rocket Scratch and was the first song to establish the turntable as a musical instrument. So for this demo, basically what we're gonna need is two things. We're gonna need the song Rocket by Herbie Hancock, and we're also gonna need to find a scratch sample. In this case, we're looking for a fresh. Shouldn't be too hard to do. For demonstration purposes, I'm going to introduce the song one more time at the drop of the verse, just to give you a little idea of what the song sounds like. I went ahead and I looped a 2-bar section of the actual scratch combo, okay? And again, this scratch involves, like I said, some basic scratch techniques that a lot of us can do, but we might not have been able to combine them in this particular way. So let's go over what the scratches are real quick. So, and again, I have my fresh on the right turntable here. We're gonna go ahead and cue up our fresh sample, and just to give you guys another idea what that sounds like. All right, and in this case, we're gonna go with the first scratch technique involved in this combination, and it's basically what we call the stab. And a stab is, again, a very short stab forward with the record, and again, only the forward sound only. We don't hear the reverse, so. And then the next scratch that we're gonna do on top of this combo is basically a quarter note, forward quarter note release. Should sound like this. Fret, and again, you don't want to let it play too long. You don't actually want to hear it say fresh, or fret. We want to hear it go fret. And then the next thing is that we're gonna combine kind of like a reverse chop. And then that's gonna go into 3 baby scratches, or in this case, we can call them scribbles. So one more time, we're gonna go over the stab, quarter note release, the reverse chop, and then the scribble. So how we're gonna combine this is we're gonna do 2 forwards, 2 stabs, quarter note release, we're gonna do 3 stabs, quarter note release, a reverse chop, and then we're gonna go into the scribbles. And again, to break it down nice and slow, it's gonna sound like this. One more time, 2 stabs and a quarter note release. And then we're gonna do 3 stabs and a quarter note release. And then we're gonna do 2 more stabs again. Quarter note release. Chop it back. And then we're gonna do the scribbles. Another cool, fun way to practice this, just like if you were learning how to play an instrument by ear, a lot of times for me in high school when I was playing the guitar, I liked to play over songs. And I would just kind of do the power chords and try to learn the song by ear. I kind of can apply the same method to scratching here, and we're gonna go ahead and go to the scratch loop. We're gonna listen to it, and like I said, I looped this for 2 bars. A good idea is to really just listen to it and then kind of get the combination in your head, and then when you're ready to go for it, you just kind of go over it, go right on top of it. Next, we're gonna take that same combination and we're gonna try to utilize it in a different way. In this case, we're gonna utilize it as a scratch in technique for mixing. Simply, we're gonna go ahead to the left record and I'm going to play it and we're gonna mix the records in and see how it sounds. Thank you. My name is Az1. Thanks for watching this episode of Turntable Techniques. Make sure to check back next month for another video. Don't forget to click like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys next time.